What? I don't know about all that.
It does. Sup?
So she said it's not her. Yeah. When she asked him about the folder, He said he turned it in.
He said he turned it in to you. Well, I'm not saying he did, I'm just saying, that's your story.
Maybe I should go ask the sheriff, I went and handed her a bunch of work, and I don't remember.
You would give me the list of things.
I'll just go ask the sheriff real quick while she's taking roll, because I wanna make sure.
That's how you wanna handle it, okay.
That I just, before you say any name, okay?
So I won't say anything, I'll just ask.
Yeah, let me just go ask her, she's taking roll.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, Mr. Long.
Woo-hoo, birthday!
Don't steal her thunder.
For heaven's sake.
It's cool, the hair is cool.
Really cool.
Yeah, you know what? I forgot the donut. But, hey, did I not bring the guitar? Did I not bring the guitar?
You brought the guitar, it was so late.
It's better than the donut.
Yeah, this fool's an egg donut, not a donut.
I cannot stand looking at your big old head. It ain't gonna work.
It is gonna work.
He can sit there.
No, there's a whole bunch of other seats.
Why can't he sit there?
Because it's uncomfortable.
I have a problem with that.
I know you do, because he's sitting there.
Okay, he can sit there, we're not going to do that. You know, don't make him sit. Listen, he's a mellow dude who says nothing to no one.
Yeah, he says everything.
Mr. Watt?
Okay, if you need to leave, you may leave the room.
Okay.
Okay, I mean, are you joking around right now, or?
Yeah.
Okay, alright, I just wanna make sure, because I mean, you know, Andrew is like, he's a mellow dude.
I don't know about that, but Mr. Watt?
He's not a mellow dude? Dude, compared to you, he's like. My forehead is shiny, really? You're gonna interrupt me in the middle of that to tell me that my forehead is shiny?
Well, whatever you were talking about.
What the hell are you laughing at? Stay off drugs.
Whatever you were talking about wasn't really important.
Hey guys, get your books up.
My God, you've been doing too much work, I think just for break?
No.
I mean, no.
Your life is a break.
I don't even have a book.
Go to Ludwig's and get one.
Hell, that's a book.
Alright, take out your book, the one that you have in there. Hey Pierce, I'm gonna have you down in here.
Oh,
Pierce.
I know. You should have come and helped me.
Oh.
No, let's be nice.
Yeah, let's be nice.
Inappropriate language, Pierce. Thank you. From now on, all of your work is science. You give to Chris. You're not gonna keep it in a folder in Baker's anymore. When you get it done, you bring it to Chris. We turn it in. Okay. Did you turn a bunch of stuff into Brashear? You don't know. Okay. Math. What's going on with math? Are you doing the work?
No, it's pretty hard.
So what about the alternative assignments? You know about alternative assignments?
Mm-hmm.
About packets? You want to start doing those?
For math?
Yeah.
I have the math book.
Okay. But you've been doing the work for Ledesma, right? Yes or no?
No, not that much.
So you haven't been turning anything in. See, you're passing the classes based on at least putting in effort. If you're not giving her any work, she's not going to pass you. But if you can't turn in the work, then you need to come to me and let me know that the work is too hard for you to do more. Because then we can either, you know, I mean, you can try it, right? And if it's not right, you can still turn it in, right? But you're not even turning it in. And that's a problem, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Libby, would you turn that off, please? Thank you. Libby, real quick, what did you, what? Thank you.
What were you going to ask me?
What a really mean look you just shot my way.
Did you know that?
Libby, what did you, excuse me.
Did you excuse me?
Or ask out, please.
What?
What did you have for dinner last night? I haven't seen.
I had spiders. Like little hamburgers.
Oh. Did you think she said spiders?
Yeah. Are you on drugs?
Yeah, I just eat spiders.
Okay, wait a minute. I wasn't the only one who thought. Other people nodded their
head. Nuh-uh.
Ernesto?
She didn't say spiders.
Shut up.
Please.
Well, I mean, she didn't say spiders. What do you mean?
I know that. I know that. I realize now as soon as she said little hamburgers, I thought she was being facetious.
Yeah, how do you have little hamburgers?
She said little hammer, and then my mind went sliders.
No,
you didn't have sliders?
He's asked me, how do you make little hamburgers? You roll a smaller.
Libby, one second, please.
I did turn it in. It's in the middle of the test week.
And they were handmade.
Just one thing. I'm so sorry.
Hey, Ernesto, please. We're trying to do some business.
I wasn't able to ask her to go into queue. What it looks like is she's giving him credit for current assignments with what's turned on.
So what we need to do is call, link the things that we turn in with the things that
right,
are in.
But there is nothing new. She doesn't post what she's doing. So she told me to just keep going with Darwin.
I see what you're saying. Okay.
So that's what I'm going to do.
So she posts it as...
She's put this as current work.
Gotcha.
Those old red ones, I don't think they're going to go away. Because this is exactly what he did. Those are in red.
Okay, so what I told him... is that the only change is that from now on he turns in all of the homework to us.
Yeah.
So we can keep track of this of the timing, okay?
I've asked you this, and you need to remember, okay?
So you had asked him to do this before?
I have asked him to turn it in.
Had you forgotten?
Never turn it into her.
I don't know what assignments, though.
Any assignments you do for biology, outside of biology, you turn them in to us. Do you understand that, or is there a problem?
The assignments that we give you. I don't care about what he does outside of. All I care about is the assignments.
As long as it's for biology.
So you make sure when you complete assignments, you give them to us, okay?
Okay, now, there is one thing that I have that he can do that is missing and it's worth a lot of points.
Okay, hold on. So we'll have him do that. Another thing is. We need to start feeding him math curriculum.
Uh-huh.
So the same assessments that we're setting up for Jenny.
Okay, I'll get them together with him today.
Okay, and we'll keep that packet. And then what we might do is have you take these packets to the Desmas, so you got work to do in there.
In there, okay.
Like Victor used to do, okay? And I'm gonna let your mom know. Now, if you guys wanna do that on the side and your tutor wants to work with you on that, that's fine. I don't care how your mom wants to handle it, but I'll let her know that that's what we're going to do. Okay.
Move the workbook. Word for word, copy every bit of that, all the pages.
I'm still holding this.
Okay, sorry to interrupt you.
That's okay. All right, Libby had sliders. Was that it?
You didn't say they weren't sliders.
They weren't sliders?
Well, you said they were handmade.
Sliders are cool.
Well, Chris, what?
Next person, Jesus. I need
hey, Ernesto. What?
What?
Is it a spider?
You don't have to say that loud, but
you're
supposed to
have
you
don't pick it up. No, I have
to. Yeah. Well,
now it's on your
shoe.
Yeah, I know.
Or spider.
You know what? I used to, they've become such a hassle in class that you guys, I shouldn't say you guys, there's a lot of people in here who created this situation where now I just kill him because yeah. I do not want to deal with it.
The world has enough.
Yeah.
Is Daichi present?
Well,
I saw him. And
was he present first?
I've already changed it.
You changed first. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Okay. I was getting my book. So here's what we're going to start doing. We need to start moving towards.
So what are we doing, rounds?
Oh, yeah. That's the one time you're okay to stand. Now, shut it down. You did your service, your public service. And now you should be quiet. Devin, wait, so you're done.
Yes.
You had sliders. Homemade sliders.
So they weren't sliders.
Oh my gosh, I'm not explaining things.
She said that. What do you have to yell?
Because
she's going
to freaking ask me.
Be quiet.
I'm not going to ask you. You're just being homemade.
Ernesto, one more time. If I got to tell you to be quiet, I'm going to send you one of these. Don't make me. Okay. He's going to.
Bye, Felicia.
We're
just waiting for that to come. Yeah, it was. Okay.
Okay. What did you want? Or did you want to talk about you? Can you put away your phone, please? Thank you. Don't roll your eyes. Jesus.
I just did.
You would think. Okay. No, don't give you that. Mm-hmm. What did you want to tell us about the sliders?
No.
You just get to sit there and pout?
No, I'm not pouting.
And
play
with
like
the chair on you.
I just don't have
to. I'm not pouting. Devin, what did you have for dinner last night? Yeah, homemade pizza.
Yeah.
Is that beef jerky?
Yeah.
That's turned out jerky.
I like jerky.
I'm
you like apples, we'll also approve. Samantha, what did you have for dinner last night?
Steak with...
Would you put that away? Thank you.
Caesar salad, cut steak, mixed it up together.
Caesar salad?
With steak in it.
With cut up steak, thrown into it, right on.
And only orange
fruit
float, and
strawberry shortcake. Ice cream.
Ice cream,
but
I swapped it,
though.
High
five. Did you give Tai Tai the...
Yes.
And
enchiladas, homemade enchiladas.
What kind? Oh, were they green or red? Green sauce or red sauce on?
It was green sauce.
Nice.
And then I tried to make brownies, but I failed.
Okay. Hey, Devin, give me a second. Can you go find Ryan, please, to see if he's out and about?
He was
here
at the beginning.
That was so sad. I put a whole cup and one half of oil in my brownies.
I hate making brownies.
Oh, what a ray of golden sunshine you are this morning.
It's just so hard to make. Like, I'm always telling you.
No, it was so bad. It was, like, crunchy.
Because of it?
Because, yeah. I put too much oil in it.
Okay.
Did it taste okay?
No. It was crunchy and hard.
Aw. Brownie jerky.
That was snarky. I admit. I needed to get that wasn't you.
You can
this
be
morning.
As snarky as you want.
Oh, now I can. Heaven forbid if you're in the grips of one of your rampages against me. Andrew? Isn't that nice that you and Tai Tai can now just live in harmony?
Why do you have to do that?
I don't know. I don't exactly. Know what. You know what?
You know that
I don't know.
You're
going
to start the war.
Exactly. War. There is no war.
Now.
Andrew? Wait a minute. Oh, the enchiladas. Were they chicken, cheese, beef, what?
Turkey.
Oh, turkey enchiladas.
I thought you were vegetarian.
I can still like meat. When I ate meat, I liked turkey enchiladas.
So you can't
go to back. You can't eat a meat like once a month.
I could, but I don't.
It's a choice.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to. There was a wedding banquet this weekend with a lot of really good food, like crazy good food at this Chinese restaurant. Yeah, and I didn't. And my cousin. Now my family doesn't know it. Other than my immediate family, the rest of them don't know. That I don't eat. And so they're like offering me wine. I'm saying no, thank you. And they're offering me, they're like, hey, you know, cousin, do you want some, you know, we got the Lazy Susan, so they're rolling it out to me. And then they notice I don't have any bones or anything on my plate. And they're like, aren't you eating? And I'm like, no, I'm good. And they said, what's wrong? I said, nothing's wrong. I'm good.
They're going to think you're anorexic.
Yeah, because I look so freaking anorexic. You know, that's kind of what I tell people, like, do I look like I miss meals? I don't think so. So anyway, and then they finally, you know, then my cousin Julia's husband, Zach, he's like, it's her birthday. If she wants to freak out, let her freak out.
Your cousin's wife's husband?
No, my
is it your
cousin?
Cousin's wife? Yeah,
I realize
cousin?
That. My cousin's wife. I meant to say, my cousin's
remember?
Husband was like, hey, you're like a guru. And I'm like, Zach, shut up. I'm not a guru. I just don't eat meat. He's like, how did you, so what was like, did you have an epiphany? And I was like, no, dude. But he's like, kind of messing with it. Zach's a good dude. And so anyway, that was it. So that was the story. But to answer your question, what I found was I made those concessions before. And then what I found, this is at least in my family, is that everybody, they saw it as then when I came over to just go ahead and cook meat. And then I realized that, you know what? They don't really care about, well, no, it's not that. It's just convenience. Now, I never told them not to cook meat. I just said, if you cook it, I'm not going to eat it. But then it's the same thing. It's like, well, then what are you going to eat? It's like...
They're worried about you. You're
right. But I'm like, you know, Mom, does it look like I'm missing meals? Like, Wallace can buy, I'll call myself Wallace to my mom. But I say, you know, I take care of myself. I know how to find a meal. So Anyway. All right, moving right along. What did you have for dinner last night, Andrew?
I had 3 burritos and 2 tacos.
What kind of burritos?
2 of them were beefy.
2 of them were beefy.
And the other one was chicken.
Wait, 2, oh, 3 burritos, so 2 beef. Why didn't you just say 2 beef and 1 chicken? Anyway, and that was it?
Yeah.
Okay, Pierce, what did you have for dinner last night? You're still digesting it, it seems.
I didn't eat anything because I slept early.
You slept early?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you sad?
No.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Birthday girl?
I have steak with black potatoes.
Ooh, and no gravy? I'm not even going to ask you because you don't eat gravy. Because you don't mind gravy.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. I shouldn't do that on your birthday.
Gravy has a lot of sodium in it. She's smart.
You know what else has sodium? Snarkiness. A bad attitude.
Because of KFC.
Excuse me.
How do we stop doing that?
I love gravy, and she hates gravy.
I'm happy for you.
I'm with her. We all love gravy.
Okay, well, clearly some of us don't.
Well, too bad. Especially if it has pieces of organs in it. Like,
what?
Some kinds of gravy has, like
the keys. Nico. Nico's like, I'm out of here. I'm living on some island, hanging out in bed, eating lamb and drinking wine all day. Ooh, you know what? If I could do that right now, be transported there, I would eat meat.
I would too.
If the condition was, you want to come to Greece, you got to eat meat, I'd be like, oh,
would you drink wine?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, I would too.
Okay, I'm fine.
I'd walk through the streets naked. The bottle of wine in one hand and a big piece of lamb in the other.
This is not a good video.
I don't want to see that in my
head. Oh, stop. No.
Why?
I'm sorry. I didn't realize. I'm sorry. Forget I said that.
Pierce, I like your shoes. Those are really cool. I just don't care.
You can't do that. You can play bad cop. Stick with the bad cop. You're like, would you put your oh, I like your shoes. They're so cool. God, you're gonna give him like he's gonna be schizophrenic by the
time. He is not. He knows
it's like a yo-yo, emotional Pierce. I'm sorry, man. Get back to work. Punk 9 to take on the bad cop. Get to work. Be quiet. You made too much noise. I'm going to tie your shoelaces together. Did you ever say what you had?
No.
What did you have?
Pasta with red sauce.
Pasta with red. Was there any like Parmesan cheese?
So spaghetti.
Not necessarily. You don't know that.
Spaghetti is what I can make.
You're starting to sound like Wallace.
Spaghetti.
Romano? You guys know the difference between a Romano pecorino and a Parmesan? Romano is made with sheep's milk.
Really?
Sheep?
Yep. Sheep. Sheep's milk. If you get what's called a Romano pecorino, so like certain parts of Italy, what you'll get is you'll get a plate of pasta, you drizzle olive oil on it, and you sprinkle Romano pecorino on it. And if it's Romano pecorino, then you know it's sheep's milk. And then if it's, would you look that up? Please, yeah. Romano pecorino. Is that sheep's milk? I'm almost certain it's sheep's milk. And then Parmesan, I believe, is made out of cow's milk.
The goat.
Not goat. Well, you know what? I can
spell
goat.
Pecorino.
Pecorino. Just type in Romano. Romano cheese. Tyler, what did you have for dinner last night?
I didn't have anything for dinner.
Okay. Jenny's lost in her work, so I'm going to leave her alone. Chris, what did you do?
Class of cheese is salty, suitable.
Is it made from?
Similar to pecorino romano, which is the same as dried and by the name.
Doesn't say what it's made of? Not made with sheep's milk?
Maybe I can
Well, I had turkey and asparagus for dinner, but I will try to look this up. Let's see. Terrible type determined by type of milk.
Checking somebody out there.
Wait, if it's preceded by the word casino, it's yeah, cow's milk. If it's preceded by the word yacarino, it's sheep's milk. Caprino is goat's milk. So you can get that. Vaquino.
What did Wallace Amato, say? What did Wallace
Vaccarino
say?
Amato,
what did Wallace
Caprino.
Hey, Amato. Listen, we be quiet.
That's like
what did Wallace say? So most people here in the United States. Nice.
She's still an angel down by the sequel.
Pierce the Quiet! It's made from sheep's milk. Dude, you are so baked right now. Good God. I'm going to call a VP.
You're making me feel freaking high.
That is my goal.
You just said United States.
I think because I said the word cheese.
Like that's like the first time.
Class, we will be studying for the United States of
America.
All right. What class is this? It's econ. All right, real quick. Hey, Devin. If you own a business that is huge, so huge that you have shareholders that are part of this business, and that you are protected from any personal liability to, with the exception of criminal liability. What kind of business is that? Is it a corporation, a nonprofit, a co-op, or a sole proprietorship, or a franchise?
Sole proprietorship.
Nope.
Corporation.
Boom. Birthday girl.
Yes.
You are part of a business with all of your classmates, and you are all members of this business. You guys get discounts. You're expected to volunteer there, say once a month, and in doing so, you get even more of a discount, though your product, your goods can be sold to the general public. And not only that, you're tied, you guys are involved in community service here. Your business, you buy your vegetables, say, at your grocery store from the local farmers. What kind of business are you? Are you a co-op, a non-profit, a corporation, a sole proprietorship, or a franchise? I don't remember what the first one was.
Co-op.
There you go. Wow. You're killing it. Whatever. Nico, your business is large. It employs many, many people. However, all of your profits go back into the business or the cause that your business represents. You cannot sell stocks. What are you? A nonprofit, a franchise, a co-op, a corporation, or a sole proprietorship? You cannot sell stocks. Very good. All right. You want to make those noises? You get the next question.
Okay.
Ooh, you sound confident. I don't like confidence.
Maybe you should pick someone else then.
You really like Andrew's clothing business. You want to sell the same products. Andrew represents the mother business, the parent company of this business. You're going to sell basically the same product, the same brand. What are you? Franchise, nonprofit, co-op, corporation, or sole proprietorship?
Franchise.
Excellent. Then the last one is sole proprietorship. Ty. No, Tyler, I haven't called on you. What is a sole proprietorship? Give us an example of a sole proprietorship. Imagine you yourself were to start a sole proprietorship. What would you be starting? What kind of regulations would you adhere to? And guys, notice I'm not asking you to, I'm on the test, I'm going to ask you these same kinds of questions. As we do the review, I'm going to ask you these same kinds of questions. So you don't have to do it word for word from the book. I just want you to know the different types of businesses.
when you have like the company, but like it's not like you are like in.
Is it public?
No.
Can you sell stocks?
No.
No.
It's not a corporation.
It is not a corporation. You own the business,
yeah.
Which means what? Are you liable?
Yeah.
So you're liable for that business. Okay? It is a privately owned entity whereby a single individual, or it can be more than one individual, but those individuals, let's say four people going on a business. Me and your stepdad have talked about starting a pizza place. Seriously. We were talking about if Winelli's ever goes for, up for sale, we want to buy it.
Will you make better pizza than Winelli's?
You know what I would do? I would do a Chicago style. I would do a deep dish pizza.
Winelli's is
good. They you know
okay.
You know where they lack their crust?
Yeah.
Right?
Okay, have you been to Roma's?
Love Roma's.
Oh my god, they're so good. The crust is so, oh my god.
Go thin crust from Roma's. Get the thin crust, listen, get
it. I love the thick crust.
Okay, that'll fair
enough. I like crust. If it's a pizza, it's thin crust. I need crust.
Fair enough, some people like crust. Alright, so sole proprietorship. So you guys seem to have a good handle on that. Let's double check. You, give me an example of a co-op. Be a little more specific. Partners. Who are the partners?
Partners.
Do you notice the magic that is going on right now? I'm thinking I'm teaching, and so like, you're making. Are you? Is like.
I'm
are
listening.
You filling the Ernesto vacuum?
Probably.
Well, please don't.
Why?
Why? Why?
Why?
Hey. Samantha, do you feel comfortable going into Ludwig's room? Do you feel comfortable going into Ludwig's? Is anyone?
I do.
Do you? Can you go and ask Ernesto that we would like him to come back and take part? If he can, without talking, we would like him to take part. Ask Mrs. Ludwig if she can ask Ernesto if he would like to take part in class instead of being away from it. So it better not be donuts.
Yeah.
Alright, just in case.
I've never had
them. I like it when you guys are
where
nice
is
to
going?
Each other. Where is she going?
Blackwood.
I just sent her. I was like, where did I just send her? I don't even know. I sent her to Ludwig so we could bring her Ernesto back. I swear to God, if he comes back. Libby! Put the freaking clothes! Okay, so we got out of the way. Quick question. Give me a definition of taxes, Devin. And when he's done giving me the definition of taxes, so you can start thinking about this right now, I'm going to ask you, how does the government, here's a hint, how does the government keep track of your taxes through what form? So, what's the definition of taxes? It's the biggest state in the union.
Really?
I mean, Texas. Sorry.
Oh my God.
That's Alaska.
Yeah, I don't know why I said that. Yeah? You think I'd say no? But don't go in there and vape. Everybody's a river. No, I'm not saying you are. I need to say that. Because that's what everyone, all these kids, the VPs are saying.
Yeah. It also goes off the fire.
Right?
Cool.
Give me a fist bump. But you gotta do the explosion.
That
was
Mr. Ross,
ass.
Me and my dad did that.
You guys?
We do like the
you guys? So my son and daughter have a whole thing. I try to get a fist bump from my son, it'll be like. And then sometimes if he's in a really good mood, he'll just kind of go like that.
Okay.
What was the question that I just asked? I asked some other question. Oh, Devin, taxes. Give me a definition of taxes.
Required payment.
To whom?
To the government.
For what?
For
services. Infrastructure. Guys, remember those two things. As far as our taxes, what they go to, it goes to government. Right? So it goes to keeping government afloat, keeping government. So in that case, because it employs legislators, it leads to laws. But really, what you guys care about government for, the rank and file, us, you know, the public, is for infrastructure and services. How do they control all of that, right? There's a lot of people living in the United States. Almost 500 million people who live here. Of that 500 million, a whole bunch of people, thank goodness, work. That's a lot of forms being sent in. What's the form that they keep track of all of this stuff? I'm giving you a major hint.
Your paycheck?
Nope.
Your taxes?
Tax form.
Tax form.
Okay? Your tax forms. Hi, Ryan.
Hello.
Ryan, since you're caught up in Barlow, he told me you're caught up, you can use, I don't want you wandering around. Ryan, come and use the computer. You may use the computer. Leave him alone, for God's sake.
Hello, Pierce Robertson.
Yeah, that's what people like, Ryan. Get right in their face. They like that. You should do that to Libby. She
Please
really
don't.
Likes
no.
Oh, then maybe we should be quiet.
I'll do that to
you.
You
should be quiet.
Okay, listen. If you do not want me to target you, don't do that to me. Because the first thing I'm going to do... I'm joking. Right?
Yeah.
Don't do that to me. That's like walking down the street and looking at, hey, don't bust me, police officer, even though I'm holding a gun in this bag full of money. Okay. The hell is my point? Through a tax form. So things like a 1040. That wasn't loud. Good God. You guys are killing me.
Are you really?
B14. Hey. Absolutely not. I told him if he kept interjecting, I would send him out. So he got up and left. And now I'm saying I would like him, we're doing a review of the concepts, and I would like him to be part of the review. I know he's, according to him, he likes to go back there and sleep. Yeah, I mean, if he's having a bad day, I'm fine with that. I didn't want him to think that he's kicked out. I had him kicked him out.
Right. Yes, sir.
He should know. Okay. Hey, thank you. Do you guys have a copy made? No. If you haven't made it. No, I'm not going to. I do not. No.
Okay, but you're in high school.
I mean, it's high school.
Rogers has
a coffee. I don't. No, I like to mix it up. I don't like to rely on this one
musical.
Yeah.
Who said yeah?
Dan.
Someone just said yeah?
Yeah, that's good strategy. Yes, Sam did.
You said yeah.
No.
Devin,
I said
yeah. Mrs. Ledwig, he won.
It was Nicole.
Yeah, you just said yeah.
Yeah. Nicole said yeah.
Yeah.
Libby said yeah.
I didn't say anything.
I'm
okay, you guys ready? Oh, you know what we haven't done?
What?
We haven't sung happy birthday. On three.
She's going to kill you.
One, two, three. Happy birthday. Okay, listen. I'm not doing this alone. Pierce, stop writing. Sing. Tyler, you better sing.
Shout it out. Ryan,
Anyone
help us.
Doesn't
happy
sing.
Birthday.
Nico, sing in Greek. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nicole. Happy birthday to you.
Yay!
Now be quiet and get back to work. Okay. Where
you never said that we have to do it last night, so you did not.
OMG.
Because you said
yes, she did. Yes, she did.
I did. I said I
no,
had
to. No, you
didn't.
You didn't say what happened. Yeah.
I didn't?
No.
Yeah, you just went right into the corporation stuff.
I had. You want to guess? Is that what you said? Okay, this is what I heard. Chili Balakawa. That's what I heard.
That's cheese fries.
Oh, well, I was close.
You had cheese enchiladas with a lot of Peppery Dio.
Pico de Gallo. I had green sauce, cheese enchiladas with lots of, well, not at.
Did you make that?
No, I got it from,
where'd you get it?
I had a late night last night as far as I finally, I didn't get home till Sacramento till late.
Where did
then I worked out. Then I went to my mom's. So then at that point, my mom kept saying, I'll make you something. I was like, no. I got it from El Forestero.
Do you stay every weekend up in?
Pretty much.
Okay.
Yeah, that will end as soon as my son, he's going to quit his job in about 2 weeks.
Why?
So he doesn't have to keep it, and he wants to move down to Sac for the summer.
Oh,
and
cool.
He's thinking of transferring to Rio.
He'll be there next year. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Next year, why would he want to come back?
His senior year.
That's good.
What's that?
So why did you want him to come back if you just kicked him out for
art? He was never kicked out. He did not. Did you guys hear me kick him out?
No.
I said, if he does this one way, and I keep, you know, moving the line on that. What I'm hoping is, with each threat, that maybe
they don't work.
I know. Well,
just don't threaten.
No. That's not the. What I'm trying to do is wear him
true.
Down.
That's because
I'm trying to wear him down.
Yeah, I remember those days.
Because if I don't say something,
you know who they wear down? They wear you down.
That doesn't wear me down.
It wore me down.
Because I'm not. I don't really care what the end result is. Okay.
The reason I asked is because I thought of calling you to get Sarah's car keys from her if you were in Sacramento, but I thought you probably wouldn't. Because she left her car.
One day.
It was Saturday morning.
I was actually
here. We were.
On Saturday morning. I was at Kaiser Hospital getting, my son was getting x-rays because he tore ligaments in his wrist.
Oh, no. What did he do?
How did he do this?
He went.
Making tacos?
And he jumped up. Here at Rio, we had worked out Friday night. So he got off work early on Friday, so he came back here and we lifted weights Friday. And he was jumped up, grabbed the basketball rim, and tried to hang on one arm and torqued his wrist.
Oh no.
Thought he was broken, it had swollen up.
Which ligament?
I don't know. The doctor said.
The ligament, it starts with the L, U.
Luanda. Lucy.
I just say that because I tore that ligament in my wrist and the swelling wouldn't go down, and so they surgically went in and they had to restring a different ligament to take its place.
Uh-huh.
So if they have to do anything like that,
they didn't have to do it, or he said they don't have to. He said it's not so severe.
Okay, good.
But he's yeah. So anyway, he said it should heal. It'd take about 2 weeks, and then this is what's funny. He said, if you guys need an excuse for work, because he had to work Sunday morning, so I had to pick him up there. Says, if you need an excuse for work, I can write you one. I said, well, does he? And so my son looks at him and goes, well, if you give me one, I wouldn't.
Is his hand in a splint?
No. Well, they were going to put it in a splint.
You should have.
You know what? So here's what I told him. He was trying to get out of work, so I didn't want to. So I asked the doctor, can I freaking finish? Thank you. Let me talk.
You wouldn't let him out of work.
No.
I remember my dad being in high school
with a broken collarbone and separated shoulder.
What is it with you guys?
I don't know. You know what? The look, so anyway, just let me finish the freaking story.
No.
So I asked the guy, I said, if he works, is it going to get worse? And he said, no. He said, it's going to, he'll limit his range of motion, it'll be painful. And I said, good. So I said,
good. You should be home icing it on Sunday.
So anyway.
I just want him to be tough.
You know what? You worry
you
about Sarah, I'll worry about Jack.
You want him to suffer.
No. What I want him to do is, I don't want him to become, listen. Anyway, my daughter is tough. She doesn't miss work. She goes when she's sick. She is seriously tough.
So you want him to be like your daughter?
I want him to be the kind of person when, if he has children, God save him. If he has children and he has a job, he's not the kind of person who's going to call him sick. He's going to go take care of business. And these little things, and he was a dumbass by doing, because I told him, I said, don't do that. He had, earlier had jumped up and was doing pull-ups on the rim, and I said, okay, that's fine, but it was dark now, and I said, I wouldn't do that if I were you. I said, you're cold, you haven't been, just finished lifting.
Yeah.
You know, and he's like, no, I got it. And then he goes and does it, and he's like, ah, damn. I thought he was joking, right? And I'm like, yeah, okay, funny. He goes, no, seriously, Dad, I think I jacked it up.
Right.
And then later he shows it to me, and it's just swollen. And I'm like, so I thought maybe it's broken.
That was a divine intervention result of your action.
So right I there. Said, you know what? So the doctor said what he said, and he says, well, I can prescribe him some painkillers. And I said, no. I said, he can live with it. My son's looking at me like, wow.
Thanks,
we got it work. I said, no, deal with it. I always tell him because his sister had teeth removed. And she had Vicodin, like prescribed her. She never took her bites. She just used ibuprofen. And I said, do you want a bite? And I went and said, honey, take a bite. Just, you're in pain. He goes, no, I don't need it. I was like, man, I can't stop. Women are the toughest people on this planet physically.
Yep.
Anyone who can perform the act of childbirth and not complain afterwards and can get back to work, that's, man.
And not strangle the nerves.
I have days where I take a really big poop and I can't work the next day. No, I'm kidding. There's another. You got that image? Give me an epidural! What?
My dad actually had to tell the doctor what to do when my mom was doing it. Because he wasn't doing it right, apparently. So my dad.
Your dad's a smart person.
Yeah.
You know what? I'll give you guys a story. This is here's a life story. Don't ever do this. Hey guys, don't ever do this to your wife or girlfriend or whatever. So my wife had just given birth to my daughter, right? And it was like a couple days later, and I had a rugby game scheduled. And I was like, I gotta play in this rugby game, you know? And she was pissed, but she was like, all right, she relented. And I said, you know, I'm gonna play in the game, and I'll come back, and, you know. So I go play in the game, and I come back, and she's sitting there, and, you know, it's like 3 days after giving birth, and she's tired, and she's holding my daughter, and she's wanting me to take, and I like kind of limp in, and she goes, what's wrong with you? And I said, stepped on it. I got corn. You guys stepped on my corn. I thought I was gonna die.
Oh.
And right then, she's just staring at me. She's like, you look at me when I tell you the way you're going. She's just staring at me. And she says to me, I quote, are you effing kidding me? And right then I thought, ooh, I should probably keep my mouth shut. She just gave her 3 days ago. I got my corn stepped on.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
But it did hurt. It freaking hurt, man. It's just, she asked.
Uh-huh.
You know, and I just realized, like, oh, I should have just kept my mouth shut. Like, everything was like, okay, here's what I should have done. Not go to the rugby game. But.
Oh, I just have to play.
And if I'm going to go. Well, her thing wasn't about she didn't want me to play, right? It wasn't this, like, what if you get hurt?
Mm-hmm.
How are you going to help me with the kid? How are you going to go to work? You know, all these things, like, dude, we got a family, like, you need to stop playing rugby until you get better insurance, because at the time, I didn't really have insurance. So, anyway. Okay. That's it.
Free.
So, taxes, and then if the government wants to check your taxes, they're going to conduct what event? You don't want this event happening to you. What?
An audit.
Very good. You guys have been studying.
Wow. I pay attention in class.
I heard her say audit, and I do.
You know what?
Ty, you're golden. Be like. No, I heard both of you. That was good. It came out at the same time. Okay, and then what does most of our taxes go to? The biggest gouge from our paychecks, from our income, is what
government.
Tax? No, don't say government. It all goes to government.
Tax for IRS.
No.
Income tax.
No. The federal. Listen, stop. It's all income taxes. So, like, all of these things being taken out of your paycheck, are all types of income taxes, Libby. But the federal income tax goes to those services and infrastructure, military, etc. Okay? And then there's other income taxes, your payroll taxes, which include, guys, look right here, these things, Social Security, Medicare, disability, unemployment. Got it? So there's other taxes that are deducted that go to that. It's all part of the government. The government runs these things. And you guys remember, I heard somebody say three letters. What's the organization, government organization? Can I ask the question? that controls the taxes? It's the IRS. And they do it through your tax returns. So it's really important, guys, when you get your W-2s, look at me right now so I know you all are listening. Tai Tai, when you guys get back your W-2 forms at the end of the fiscal year, which will be about January, February, make sure you keep those. Because in order to fill out your tax return forms, if you guys do them yourself. Now, here's what happens, especially with young people. Most people ignore it. Don't ignore it. Because you're probably, especially if you're not making a lot, if you're making between 10 and 20 bucks an hour, and if you're making, say, $15 an hour, and you have two or three kids, you could be getting back a lot of money from the government. You guys following me here?
Yeah.
So do not ignore that stuff. It would be absolutely foolish. You're throwing away money. You might be throwing away like a thousand or thousands of dollars. So for the first 3 years of my fiscal life, as I was getting back these tax returns, and I think I told you about this before, I would throw them away. And one day my mom found it in my wastebasket. She says, "What's this? Why did you throw this away?" And I said, "I don't want the government to blah, 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 blah." And she goes, "Listen, dumbass, they already got you on their records. That's why they sent this to you. You just threw away money." And she opened it up and she said, "Look, there's 800 bucks they're returning to you. You just threw that away." So don't ignore that stuff. It is complicated, but it's worth it. If you can't get someone to help you, you can find, and especially like you seniors, if we talk about agency linkages, we talk about something like ALTA or DOR, these agencies, you could probably find people within them to help you with it. Got it? And sometimes people will go to a tax return company like H&R Block, right? And they'll charge you like 250 bucks. Now, if you're getting back thousands of dollars, it might be worth going to one of those companies. Or they have software that crunches the numbers for you. All you do is you take the numbers from your W-2, and they'll say from line 4C, take that number, you put it in there, and then the software will crunch it for you and spit out a number, and that's the number that you either owe the government or the government is going to pay back to you. And again, you guys, when you start working out based on probably the price, the wage that you're going to make, and I don't mean this like you don't have the potential to make more than this, it's just most young people, myself included, made very little money early on. Just because we lack experience, or no one's going to hand you a $100,000 a year job, right? Until you've proven your worth, or you've shown them your responsibility or your knowledge. So make sure you take advantage of your tax returns. Okay, so the IRS oversees it. And then property taxes, I just want you to know they exist. It ain't going to probably matter to you guys early on. Okay? You alright?
No, I'm dying.
We're all dying.
We're all dying,
sweetheart. We're all dying. Some of us just sooner than others. Alright. And then four types of banks, okay? I want you guys to today we're gonna read about the stock market. Okay? In case you guys start playing the stock market. So if anyone ever says something to you like, "Hey, you know, let's say you go work for Google or Goggle or whatever it's called, or you go work for, you know, some big tech company," and even if you start in on the ground floor, and I told you before, my cousin was like, "Dude, come here and be a custodian." And when you go and sign your contract, ask for profit sharing. And if he would have gotten that job and I would have done that, I probably could be a millionaire today. Really, although I probably would have blown it on freaking
water.
I would have blown it on I would have blown it on stupid things, but, you know.
Like what?
You know, actually, I wouldn't have, because when this happened, you know what? When it happened, I just got married and had a kid. So I would hope I wouldn't have blown it on anything stupid back then. On frivolous things, toys, new mics, don't look at it. Why don't you turn it face down so it doesn't distract you? Like, we're having a conversation about economics, but you're so interested in that. And that has nothing, like, does that person care about your knowledge of economic realities?
Probably.
No, probably not. Yeah, they're economic. Hey, can you go in on this dime bag with me?
Yeah. First of all,
what?
I need, before you leave, I need to tell you something.
Okay.
So,
is it critical?
Well, if you're still lecturing, I don't want to.
No, I'll stay here at 4.
Oh, I just wanted you to know I ran
you
into.
You can tell it anyway. I like how you fit that in.
Well, I ran into Rinda sitting on the bench.
Did you say Rinda?
Said
Rita. Oh, I think you said Rita.
Rita.
Okay, yeah, you're talking to Rita.
Oh, I see. Nice.
I ran into her sitting on the bench outside his bench with her phone.
Okay.
And I asked her what she was doing and when she was going to finish her test and if she got a book. No, I can't have a book. I said, well, you finish your test. Oh, I'll do it fifth. I said, why are you sitting on the bench? Well, they're correcting the test. I said, you need to mark yourself over here and work on your test. And she didn't. Just FYI. She made a choice not to. And she's sitting on it, but having a good time with the phone. So.
If the teacher sent her out.
Right. But in the meantime, I'm emailing him constantly that she's not done with the test yet and she's not putting in time on it. I said, so you're just not going to do the
let's
test.
Just, let's, I'll deal with
it. I just wanted you to be aware.
I didn't know about the whole book thing and we'll yeah, something has to be.
Should I borrow a book?
Not done yet. Have a seat. I got another question before you leave.
I can stand. No. You can ask me the question.
That's fine, you can stand. 4 types of banks, what are they? Libby, give me 1 type of bank.
Commercial.
Give me a second type of bank. It's your birthday. Thank you. Give me a third type of bank. So we got commercials, commercial banks, savings and loan, what? No, be more specific.
Auto credit union.
There you go, credit union. Give me the 4th type of bank. We got commercial. We got savings and loans, or S&Ls, and we got credit unions. Give me the 4th. No, you're still not going yet, soul sisters. Just be patient. Real estate, if you're wheeling, dealing a lot of real estate, remember, it's a type of bank.
Savings.
Nope.
A saving bank, it's not going to fail.
Yeah. Yeah, savings.
Oh, yeah. I'm just testing you,
wow.
Girl. Give me 1. So banks, give me, I'm going to point to you. If you can answer this correctly, then you may leave. And then I'll point to somebody else. You want me to point to you?
No. I forgot to get all my stuff from the strategies room.
Go get it.
Yeah.
Just
ask the question.
Give me 1 service that you can get from your bank.
Give me that.
Be specific. Don't be general. And you'll be next.
I think Mr. Wallace wants you here.
Be more specific. When you say savings?
Oh, no. Share box.
Gotta ask
him. No. Savings. Savings account.
Here's here today for it, or with this paper? Did you do those other packets?
He did do that.
And I turned him in.
And so we have 2 packets to start.
He got this. He's
let's come back and finish that here. Okay? All right. Here, she's getting taller. You're leaning out. Where the rest of you going? We got savings, we got our savings accounts, we got loans. Give me another service that they do. Big car, you go into the store, you want to buy something, you always have to use money.
Yeah.
No.
Debit.
AKA your ATM.
Credit card.
Credit card's very good, debit. Give me another service. Are you having a tough time with that there?
Yes, it's annoying. I'm trying to get it.
It's getting twisted. Why don't you just wear it over your shoulder like a bandolier? You know what to do? And then put your arm through it. No. So here's what you want to do. You don't tear it. Wear it this way.